Hi, this is a summary of David Hornik's visit to the Dyslexia Explored podcast, telling his dyslexia story. Here we've got the image of David meeting with people as a venture capitalist, helping tech companies grow fast. It all began for him, the foundations started in a home of lifelong learners. He talks about how they would have so many conversations around the dinner table with an encyclopedia behind them. And if they ever had a question, they would go straight to the encyclopedia and discuss it and debate it. And there was lots of debate. And tell us about the journey from childhood to getting a job as a venture capitalist. So life began around the dinner table, discussing life, learning about things, and he didn't realize his dyslexia or the effects of it at all. He intuitively started to get his younger brother, to read for him, etc. And it wasn't until they moved and transferred to a school where they had a gifted program in the high school, and his brother and sister were included in it, but not him. And his mother fought hard for him and wondered why he wasn't included as well. And that's when he got tested for dyslexia and identified, and he was included in it. And he shares this fascinating story about how his mum, who was so determined to help him share what he knew and learn well at school, and some interesting techniques. His mother taught him how to write stories and essays by getting him to write notes, and then he stood and he spoke out from his notes to his mum, who typed out the essay for him. And he's found that actually listening to even himself speaking helps him get his thoughts into his head. So that's why we've got these sort of audio branches happening here. Long story short, he got into law school. He went to Stanford and eventually got into law school as well. And now he's even teaching part-time in Stanford and Harvard. So what did he learn from his time in college? Well, there was a significant difference between having his mother help him go through all of his work and the independence of college. One of the fascinating things that David shared was how he learned to survive in college by learning to work with people. He realized that it's important to understand how the teachers are working and what they need, to understand that it's not just, you're not just in a school system or a college system, that it's made up of people. And when you realize and treat your college teachers as people, they help you succeed. Once you create that bond with them and they like you and you like them, they help you succeed. So he realized also in his first year he had to work really hard before he understood the whole system. And then one of the interesting factors he found out was, once you figure out what matters to your teacher, then you can give them what's important to them. And that's when he found that his ability to build up relationships and play the game of school, of college, of life, it's not just about the rules of the game, it's also about the people and the relationships there. That's when he became a lawyer, and that led him into the tech world. So long story short, he started getting into startups, started to help startups. And one of the things he drew out of experience with startups is that often as an entrepreneur or in the tech world, you get, with dyslexia, you get to choose the shape of the field, the players in the field, how you're going to work in that field of work. And that's a huge advantage for dyslexics in this fast-moving tech world where things are changing rapidly and problems are needing solved. And he found that this relationship-building ability of his was what led him into venture capitalism, meeting with lots of people, learning from lots of people by speaking to them and hearing them, and then giving them money to help them grow faster. So what we learn here is that in this podcast, there's so much richness about the value of relationships, how it can help you with dyslexia work with your dyslexic strengths and limitations and advantages, and how school isn't just about bricks and mortars and systems, but it's about people and relationships. And if, as a person with dyslexia, you can learn to read people, often you've got the ability, the latent ability to read people, understand to them, relate to them, and that long-term relationships, building them, especially with your teachers, so you can show to them that you're really interested in the work and you appreciate them, then you can bring them on side. And also learning the system of school as well, that it's not just about learning everything you need to know, but understanding what the school system wants from you. So this map was brought to you and hand-drawn by bulletmapacademy.com. And if you want to know more about what David shared, go to Dyslexia Explored and find out more in whatever podcast service you use.